Kevin Durant is going to the Nets, according to our Adrian Wojnarowski, where he will join Kyrie Irving and DeAndre Jordan. So a new super team in New York, not the New York a lot of people were expecting earlier this year, but over in Brooklyn, we will be talking about that. We also talk about the Warriors, why the Warriors' pitch didn't work. First, though, it's still the jump, so it's time for a little make or miss.
Oh, yes.
Make, miss. It's a make or miss league.
Oh, that laugh has new context, doesn't it? Miss the Bulls! Former Pacers guard Darren Collison expected, right, to maybe sign with Chicago. Instead, he retired on Friday. Now, local reports in Chicago did say the Bulls were in talks with him. Brian, are you surprised by Collison's decision? I know the Lakers were interested in him too, right?
He could have probably gotten $10 million or more. He's coming off two seasons where he shot the three ball very well, would have been very in demand. But he's going to do what he's going to do. He has his own will.
A lot of jokes on Chicago sports radio shows I heard after this about what people will do to not sign with the Chicago Bulls. Make the bag. According to multiple reports, Nico Mirotic is leaving the NBA to sign with Barcelona in the EuroLeague for a lot of money. Ramona, what do you think of this decision?
I was as surprised by this one as I was by Darren Collison retiring. I mean, he was going to make a lot of money in the NBA.
Okay, but the report I saw said what? Almost 100 million?
70 million euros.
Right.
Which is the largest contract ever given
in the history of the
history of the
U.S. is 90?
I don't know what the conversion is. It's a lot of dollars.
It's a lot of euros. A lot of pounds.
Yeah. And by the way, this is a guy who lived in Chicago, New Orleans, Milwaukee Nuggets, lived in Barcelona.
That's true. Is this Luka Doncic's old team?
No, he's played for Real Madrid.
Okay, well, you know, it's certainly
same country though, Rachel.
Barcelona.
<sure. laughs> I just know he's fluent in Spanish now, and I'm impressed. Miss Daps, big three action. Royce White, Frank Robinson hanging there.
Frank Nitti.
I mean, we've had some. Look at that. Look at that.
Royce.
We have had some all time great left hand moments.
That's so good.
Phil, man.
Great. And Phil Jackson, by the way, a veteran of these. Like, Russ will make sure you do not leave him hanging. And this is my favorite Phil Jackson one, because then he starts to zap himself up.
Sort of.
We've had some other ones. Remember, of course, Kawhi was not having it when Norm Powell tried to do it. Kawhi explained to me later that he thought Norm was trying to go in for, like, everybody in the tunnel going in.
The Phil one is the best. Now.
Make unicorns. Our friend, indeed, I just mentioned, Luka Doncic, posting a picture on his IG story with an inflatable unicorn.
Why does he have that?
Me and Kate Porzi. Why does anyone have anything, Brian?
Because he can.
What are your expectations for this dynamic duo?
Well, first of all, we got to make sure that he's healthy enough to go, right? We got to see how he looks. But then the other part of it is, this is a nice kind of tandem when you talk about a great pick and roll player in Porzingis, Doncic, and Porzingis can pop, can roll, can do a lot.
Mavs have cap space. Their team isn't done at all. We're going to see two additions at least, I think, in the next 24 hours for them.
Spicy. We've got little super teams, baby super teams, super team lets cropping up all over the NBA.
That's a team.
And right now, one of the ones that is attracting the most attention is that, indeed, according to Woj, Kyrie Irving will meet with the Nets today in New York to reach a four-year, $141 million maximum contract. So you guys heard me asking Woj this in the opening segment. How did this change from the Knicks, when Jim Dolan has owned this team the whole time? So you cannot tell me it was like, well, you know, Jim Dolan owns that team, and that's a red flag for some players. This is not new, right?
Well, it's what Ramona was saying, is that KD wants to play with his friends, right?
And that Kyrie is the one what drove all of this?
Pretty much. Because Kyrie is the one that, from the beginning, when they would say Knicks, says he don't want to play for the Knicks, right? And so, if the interesting question is, if Durant never gets hurt, does this turn into a split decision? Does Durant have more sway to say, no, I'm going to New York. What are you going to do? I don't care. Him being hurt almost needs like an insurance policy that there's going to be another star who can hold it down for the year while I'm out. And so it put more leverage, I guess, into Kyrie's camp.
Let me cover three things real quick. The Nets have been working on this. Kevin has a relationship with Torian Prince, who they traded for quietly around the draft. They obviously been working on DeAndre Jordan.
Right.
That team, by the way, is loaded now.
Yes.
Very deep, even without Durant this year. And as Ramona said, he wants to play with his friends. Isn't that code for my friends weren't Warriors?
And I think that's the big issue here is We just talked about the Hamptons Five. I remember where I was when I saw the Players Tribune with the picture of them.
Stretching it, yeah.
Right? In the, he was in the garden or something.
My next chapter.
My next chapter. You know, that was real. When the Warriors went out there, when the Hamptons Five met with Kevin Durant, that was a real bond. Like, that first year, was a real friendship. They had a real bond. I remember being in Oklahoma City that first time when everyone was wearing cupcake shirts afterwards. Remember?
I was there.
It was a hostile environment, and they had his back.
And Draymond Green had his back. Remember?
Had his back.
To a fight.
And over the course of a couple of years that he's been there, he's won there. He was FaceTiming with Klay Thompson when Klay Thompson tears his ACL, saying, we're going to come back stronger than ever. Klay Thompson has been calling him the entire time since the season has ended. Steph Curry has been in touch. Bob Myers has been in touch.
So The Athletic's Marcus Thompson reported that Steph, who's been over in China, came down through New York.
Yeah, he was flying home from Shanghai.
With the intention of then, while he was stopping over in New York, to meet with KD. Do we know if that happened?
I don't know if that happened. I've been trying to check on that all day because I know there was a flight from Shanghai back, but I don't know if it was back.
By the way, I'm not asking about, like, Marcus Thompson is the most reliable source when it comes to Steph Curry. I just don't know if KD made his decision before Steph's plane landed, and therefore the meeting might not have happened.
He can maybe just keep flying all the way.
Can you tell the pilot? Like, just
I don't have the private plane records, but I did see that report as well, and I was checking on that. Mm-hmm. The sense I have, though, is that the Warriors tried, right? Whatever friendships that he had there, all of those guys reached out. All of those guys made him feel like he was welcome back. They were going to offer him the 5-year max. There was definitely a consideration that maybe he signs a 5-year max and then can be traded later, as you spoke about
also,
earlier.
This is not over. As Woj mentioned, there's a possibility that the Nets could do business with the Warriors. There's a bunch of sign and trade maneuvering here. We have Kyrie coming to Brooklyn. We have potentially Terry Rozier going to Charlotte. We have Kemba Walker going to Boston. We have Durant going to Brooklyn. This is very complicated, but there's a possibility that they could work it all in a 4-team sign and trade and move all those teams around where the Warriors could end up with something that they can use here. So it behooves the Warriors to act like grown-ups, which I'm expecting them to.
Sure.
And to continue to try to work with KD here. Business is not closed.
And I know the CBA was different, so there were different rules on sign and trades at that time. But even Dan Gilbert, after he wrote the Comic Sans letter, worked out a sign and trade with Miami to at least get some benefit.
Two firsts.
To get
2 seconds. They got 4 picks.
To get LeBron down to the Heat. So you mentioned what the Nets have, and you heard me ask Woj about a possible sign and trade, and D'Angelo Russell is sitting there.
That would be an incredible recovery.
With Kyrie Irving now going to the Nets, where does this leave D'Angelo Russell, and could you see him going to the Warriors, or could you see him going to one of these other teams?
Well, we know he's not going to be back in Brooklyn. He's going to be gone from Brooklyn. The reports are that he's going to meet with Minnesota. Minnesota would have to make a deal with Brooklyn probably for that to happen. But this would be a remarkable recovery if the Warriors could pull this off. They actually could execute this sign and trade. It would be complicated. I don't want to make it sound like
this is a
simple phone call and let's do it. The Warriors would have to sell themselves to D'Angelo Russell. They would have to agree on a contract, and they would have to do that sign and trade. But it's not out of the realm of possibility that they could get D'Angelo Russell, especially if the Lakers use their cap space on Kawhi Leonard,
and the
Lakers are no longer an option for him, and he has the potential to go to the Warriors and where he could be part of a perimeter. Remember, Klay Thompson will not be there at the start of the season, but he may rejoin after the All-Star break, and that perimeter may be a really compelling perimeter. So it's not over here for the Warriors, even though this is a huge setback. They've got to work very hard, and knowing them, they were preparing for this. They were preparing for Kevin leaving to try to do this.
Up until the finals, I think they've been bracing for this the entire season. Everybody has had that sense from the whole season. I think we talked about this many times throughout the year.
It almost seems like after Kevin got hurt, there was a renewed sort of coming together of everyone being like, hey, you're our brother. You sacrificed for us. We feel like we owe you something. Obviously, the narrative on Kevin Durant changed a lot, right? From someone who maybe joined a winner or bandwagoned on to someone who they needed, right, in this finals, and him not being there obviously had a huge effect on the fact that they lost those finals. For D'Angelo Russell, though, just as we wrap up this part of the discussion, we've heard reports that he is very eager to play with his friend Karl-Anthony Towns. If he is renounced, he can sign with anyone for as much money as he wants. There's no restriction on him, right?
Yeah, I mean, there's no fear of the Nets matching and saying, we'll keep them. The scenario that Brian described about maybe the Warriors getting on it, the only thing there that complicates it is the idea that then they would be operating as an under the luxury tax team, and so then they get hard cap. The other scenario that we talked about in the break that I thought was pretty interesting that you said is that the Warriors make a deal for just a trade exception, and then that way they have a year to spend
37.2, I believe.
$37.2 million on one player, a couple players, whatever, and then you can renounce the rest in order to make sure that you're still under that hard cap of the luxury tax.
It's going to be very interesting, and I'm also interested in what we get from, man, our whiteboard. We just had another loss on the whiteboard. I don't know if you can see that at home.
It's not really available.
it's not going well for us. I mean, you're going to have to get over and make that happen while I'm talking so stickies here.
If anyone at home has tape,
please come down to our LA studio with a roll of tape, and we can see what we can do here. But I am interested in what happens with D'Angelo Russell, because he just played his best season ever in what we in the NBA like to refer to as a contract year, right? He played above his percentages. The shots that he took, if you look at the averages according to Second Spectrum of their likelihood to go in, they went in more than their likelihood to go in. So it is going to be very interesting to see how far a team goes to get him. And then he will have to show us over this next season if that price was worthwhile or not. It's going to be great. It's prove it for him, and I love that. All right, coming up, we are going to talk more about the Warriors and what they do next. Amin is going to fix our whiteboard. There's all kinds of stuff coming.
I heard that was only happening in the last break.
The crank is ready because 6 p.m. is coming, guys. It's coming.